my friends, it's Warren. I am back, Bizak, with another tutorial as usual. And it's Paranoid Android by popular request. And I should also remind everybody, I have a Facebook page dedicated to shameless self-promotion. Just kidding. It's for Radiohead, like, discussions and stuff, music theory discussions and stuff, and, you know, it's just a clever way to get you guys to, you know, look at my band, too, which is, like, linked over onto the side of that page. Phonofield. Phonofield.com. But yeah, anyway, let's get on with the tutorial. this guy. And also, almost forgot, Skype lessons. Skype me. Alright, so here we go. It's gonna be in standard tuning. That's EADGBE. That's our best friend, okay? Very, very cool tuning, which is versatile, you know? So here you go. It's gonna start with a kind of a C minor shape. So here we go. It's gonna be 8, X, X-ish, 8, 8, okay? Now I say ish because, as you guys know, sometimes Tom just gets carried away. He'll kind of get to violent strumming from time to time. And so sometimes you'll hear it open. Sometimes you'll hear this one open too. But in the live versions, he is definitely not playing them as if they are like parts of the implied harmony. They're kind of just incidental notes, not as exact as you would expect such a perfectionist. But I mean, it's just part of the emotion of playing. So anyway, so it's gonna go like this. Okay, so did you catch that? That was down, down, up, up. Okay, now if you notice on the downs, I hit the sixth string, okay, and on the ups, I hit the second and the third string. So when you get used to this kind of motion, you go, okay, you're just going to be able to pick out the different notes and kind of make it more melodic, okay, rather than just a static chord, you know. So it's definitely dynamic, it's moving, it's down, down, up, up, down, up. Okay, so the full pattern there is down, down, up, up, down, up. It's like a very standard, you know, folk strum, but when you break it up and you add these notes, it sounds super awesome, so. Okay, next thing I did was I moved the middle finger, which was on the 8th fret, to the 6th fret, okay? This is kind of like an A chord with a suspension and a 6 in it, but yeah, right. I mean a B flat. Nazis are gonna get me. Okay, so B flat. Oh, you don't hit that open E, that's for sure. You always get rid of that one, so. Do as I say, not as I do. Then the next one, okay? Some people play it without the index finger, like I'm showing you now, but I play it with the index finger, and Tom does too sometimes. So this next chord is X 8 7 8 8. Okay, now these two fingers didn't go anywhere. Okay, they stayed there. So same thing, you know. Don't worry too much about the exact strings you're hitting. Get the bass on the downs, the trebles on the ups, and that's all you gotta worry about. This is actually a F dominant 9, okay? F dominant 9, very bluesy chord, but it doesn't sound like blues in this context because it's just a brilliant chord progression. Oh, so that one was a open 5th string, okay? And remember, these two fingers haven't gone anywhere yet. And then you add the index finger again back on that B flat. Okay, so I'll show you the whole thing again. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, 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 down. You see that? Open 5th string, 6th string, 6th fret. you slide down to here, same shape as before, okay? So the shape here is 3x033. It's a G minor. Same strumming pattern, and then you go open fifth string again, hit it twice, and then you do first fret. And now this is going to take some clever muting, okay? So you're going to need to mute the sixth string so you don't hit it by accident, and you're going to need to mute the fourth string. Now you ask, Warren, how can you do such a thing? That's ludicrous. How do you mute two strings? You're clearly not doing anything crazy with your left hand. I'm like, oh yes I am. So the index finger right here, the tip of my index finger is touching the sixth string, okay? And then the fleshy part of my index finger is also touching the fourth string. So look at that. I can actually mute two strings with one finger while I'm playing the note in between them, okay? Okay, and this will come in handy for your guitar career, okay? So please learn this. It's actually very, very helpful, okay? Okay, so... okay, so you got that? One, two, three, and four. Okay, now this one, some people use a low E, but I don't think Tom does, so I'm not going to show you that. The version I play of this chord is X, X, 2, 3, 3. Okay, so now, again, these fingers didn't go anywhere. Oh, now you see I strum all the notes at once instead of doing the single bass note again, okay? Like before. So here we go. I'm going to show you basically the strumming pattern right here. It goes... Now that thing I did with my fingers just now, I just went like this. I went 2-3-3, which where it was before, and now it's 2-2-3. Now you notice I have my finger mashing it down here, index finger mashing down the fourth and third strings to get that 2-2 there. Okay, so XX 2-2-3 here, and then XX 2-0-3. So my index finger was smashed here, and then it pops up for the open third string there. Okay, so I'll show you again. 2-3-3, 2-2-3, 2-0-3. Can you see it? Get my fingers out of the way. Okay, there you see it. Okay. The rhythm goes 1-E and a 2-E and a 3-E and a. Okay. 1-E and a 2-E and a 3-E and a. Okay. So for those of you who are familiar with the vocalizations, so then it repeats. Okay, and then chord, but now you're going to open up the E. I told you to mute it earlier, but now you're going to open it up for this chord. Down, down, up, up. If you notice, I'm doing the down, down, up, up, again, down, down. Now that's going to go from G minor to F now. F add 6. So 1-3-X-2-3-0. Okay? Now you can play that with your index finger or your thumb, but make sure you mute that fourth string. This is an E7 now, okay? So we're gonna go 0-2-0-1-3-0, okay? Okay, so you see that I went 10, 9, 8. I am. Oh, sorry. When I am king, you will be first against the wall. Okay, yeah? With me? All the beginners are like, no. It's okay, you'll get it. Practice, it'll come with time. What's that? Okay, part 2 to come.